man, does he look fitter to you than he was in his last fight with you, or less fit, Muhammed?
I would say I think he's about maybe 2 or 3 pounds lighter.
2 or 3 pounds lighter.
I would say about 2 or 3 pounds lighter. Let's say about 216. I'll give him about maybe 2, 13, 2, 14 pounds. Maybe 13.
George, one question to ask you. Both of these fellows are capable of dishing out tremendous punishment. One does it with one punch, the other does it over a period of rounds. How can you, or can you just make a comment on that for our worldwide audience?
Well, I would say that, my man has over here been able to give it out dishy. I think that George is capable of dishing it out. I don't know about taking it, but as a big man, he's a big man. He should be able to take most anything.
Well, that's the view of a man who should know. A man who should know. Joe Frazier's going to stay here with us and watch the fight with us. It's getting very close to fight time. Blow by blow commentary is going to be by Mr. Bob Sheridan. He'll be taking over in a moment or two to give us a blow by blow. And at the end of the first round, we'll come back, Joe, for a comment from you.
Well, I think it should be a real good fight. And somehow, you guys just got me here working. How about that? I come have a vacation and watch the fight. Hey, I'm calling Blow. Blow. For free.
Boy. Well, next time you're going to get $5 million to work on your time.
Yeah, how about that? Good. I don't mind doing that. Good.
That's a nice thought.
Jim around, so therefore, it's always nice being in his company and yours.
Well, you know I love you, Jim.
Look at this now as they stare. Muhammad Ali beginning to talk to George Foreman. They're really putting the stare on each other. George Foreman has that serious look. Ali definitely talking to him. Look at the stare on George Foreman. Look at Ali giving the word. So the stage is set. We're just about ready to begin. Round one, the heavyweight championship of the world at stake. There can be no more pure form of sport than a heavyweight championship fight. Two individuals, finely tuned athletes, climb into the ring. This time, the championship is at stake, and $5 million will be paid to both fighters. Ali ready, Foreman ready. We're waiting for the opening bell. The enthusiasm begins to mount here. One thing we want to look out for is just how fast this man, George Foreman, will open. As we mentioned, in his past several fights, he hasn't gone in the past 4 years beyond 2 rounds in any fight. Can Ali advance and stay away from him? Is George Foreman's thundering punches going to be too much for him? Is the left hook that is so devastating, a tremendous left hook, going to stop Ali? Here we go, Ali quickly across the round. Round one, Ali bouncing around, shifting left to right. George moves for Ali, gets the first punch in, a light right hand, taken on the forehead by George Foreman, the champion. Foreman moving slow, trying to start the plan. Ali looks like he's ready to go here. He's not staying away, he's going after the plan. Foreman's in bed, Foreman a bit cautious in the first round, looking to drop that left foot. Foreman dances now, moves Ali with a right hand lead again. Now Foreman slightly confused with that right hand lead, which I haven't seen too many times before. Ali certainly dancing, slipping punches, sliding around both ways. Foreman's idea is to bag him off in the corner, and when they get tight, to wail away with a vicious hook to the body of Muhammad Ali. Ali lashes out with a light left. Direct from Zaire, Africa. That punch did no damage. That one did. Two wild right hands taken on the side of the head of Muhammad Ali. Ali continues to try to dive and a back plate separates him. Wild left hand, fits the hook. There's a real strong right hand just at the end of the heart. And Muhammad Ali is taking some punishment now. About 25 seconds left in the round. Ali, face left, goes to straight right hand. A right hand lead has George Foreman slightly confused, but a straight left jab, 4x4, has Ali in the corner. Ali gets it back, hangs on. What a tremendous, tremendous finish. And round number one, the hook to the body of Muhammad Ali. Zach Clayton, the referee, separates him. About 8 seconds left in the round. Round one, Foreman and Ali. Here we go, round number two. The determined Ali get off the stool in between rounds. George Foreman sat down all the way. Ali with the back up against the rope. He's talking to Foreman still. Ali tries to tie him up. No real damage done in that exchange at all by either fighter. Round two just underway. A wild left hand that George Foreman throws is trying to get to Ali. I can't see any puffiness over the right eye of George Foreman at this point, although Ali has hit him on the butt. Ali is definitely hit-humming with his right hand lead. A good right hand taken on the left side of the jaw by Muhammad Ali, and there's those vicious hooks to the midsection of Ali. Ali has a tremendous strength to the midsection. George Foreman is head-hunting himself. Ali tries to hang on. The pace not quite what it was in round one. Ali backs up. Leans out, takes advantage of the reach. Foreman tries to work the body. Neither one of those punches did any damage. None of those punches are doing any damage at all. None, absolutely none. There's Ali flicking left hand in the face of George Foreman. Foreman pushing the head back of Ali, and Ali hangs on. The hanging on back is important for Muhammad Ali, who must take a breather now and then. Left hand, light left, taking on the chin of Ali. Wild left hand is not scoring, not getting through. Left jab, right in the button, thrown by Ali. Another left jab. Ali throwing in slipping speed as Foreman continues to wail at the body of Muhammad Ali. Another left hand on the right eye of George Foreman. The right eye that was cut in training. Still cannot see it puffy at all. George Foreman continues to stalk Ali. Tries to get through with a straight left jab, an improved left jab. There's a vicious, awkward, but very powerful hook. Both hands, left hooks, and what we're going to give the right cross is a hook to George Foreman. Misses the left hand. Ali fighting in the punch. Shows him the tremendous Ali flipping the punches as he twists the body to the side. Ali backs up and jabs it back up. About 45 seconds left in round two. An even fight to this point. Pace definitely slowed down in round two. Oh, a great left hand! An over and under combination. Left hand and the right on the jaw. Taken by the champion, George Foreman. There's a left hand in the eye of Foreman. Ali scoring some punches here. These punches are not hurting him, and he's taken on the side of the head. 30 seconds left in round two. Look at Ali. He continues to jump and talk. Definitely scores. Tremendous combination by Muhammad Ali. The left hand and then a straight right to the jaw. He's trying to do the damage with the left jab, a lightning flicking left to the right eye of George Foreman. 10 seconds left in round number two. Now he's pulling what he did against Joe Frazier. Shaking his head. No, no, he says. The left hand gets thrown in. There's the bell ending round two. We were able to observe a little bit of puffiness under the left eye of George Foreman. The left eye, not the right eye. Oh, what a combination landed by Ali in the face of George Foreman. Round three is underway. Very even fight. I will have to score round two slightly in favor of Muhammad Ali. There's the left flicking in the face of George Foreman. George Foreman backing Ali to the rope. There's a vicious left hook to the body. Misses the left again, right to the body. Thrown by George Foreman. Ali is getting away, hanging on to the head of Foreman. Foreman will push and try to set up the punch. Watch him push. There's the right hand. When he pushes, he tries to do it off the bat. That's his secret. Continues to work downstairs on Muhammad Ali. Round three, very close. Heavyweight championship fight. Ali on the left. Foreman misses the right hand. Ali scores with his own right. Foreman setting him up against the rope. Foreman misses. Ali. Ali definitely good, no damage again. Kicking it to the head of Muhammad Ali. A gut punch to it. He's in the fourth round against Muhammad Ali, the dancing master with tremendous hand speed. The left hand scores again. Foreman looking for the opportunity. Looks, has a tremendous look of determination. Stagger! Foreman stagger! Definitely! Right on the button! Right on the jaw of George Foreman! That's probably the hardest Foreman has been hit since Gregorio Peralta opened his eyes in the first fight. Another right hand taking the left side of the head of George Foreman. Foreman's face beginning to show signs of puffiness around the right eye, but below the right eye. Wild right hand thrown by Foreman. Misses the intended target, the jaw of Ali. Foreman tries to score. Ali ties him up in tight. Zach Clayton doing the job, separating the fighters. Ali rifles the right to the head of Foreman. Foreman tied up. Ali is getting away with it, tying his man up. As Ali faces him, Foreman, the strength in his back, you can see, as he tries to work downstairs on Ali. Ali hanging on and continues to get away with it. Ali looks a bit concerned, but what would you expect in there against George Foreman? Foreman not scoring these punches at all. Light barring punches, unusual for George Foreman. Maybe the heat is getting to George Foreman, as his legs at that point looked a bit on the rubbery side. Ali scores a light combination there, no serious damage done. Both fighters beginning to show signs of a little bit of tired now. And you have to expect it with the temperatures close to 80 here in Zaire, Africa. Neither one of those punches were damaging to the body of Ali. George Foreman's legs look almost weary now. He does not look strong on the legs to me at all. Right hand missed, the second one just clipped Ali in the back of the head. Muhammad Ali, straight left hand, out of left hook. Trying to catch the right eye of George Foreman, no doubt about it. Ali hanging on behind the head. Foreman hasn't been able to push Ali off and set him up. Misses the right hand. Ali is definitely confused. 30 seconds left in round four. Foreman continues to come on. Ali backs up. Not as much certain as we expected. Ali hanging tough, not coming in and moving out. Left hand misses over the shoulder of Ali, and again Ali hangs on. Zach Clayton, the referee, separates the two fighters. There's a vicious punch! No real serious damage done! Ali is getting his hand up! A wild left by the jaw of Ali! Look at Foreman's face, he does look tired! He doesn't have the top of his legs! expectations, John Day. And it's absolutely fantastic. And Ali is winning all the way for me. And I think he's going to win it within another 4 rounds.
A prediction there. A prediction there from John Day on Ali. Judge Fraser has been watching this, and he's got a word to say in praise of the referee. We've got a replay coming up, though, right now. Here's a replay coming up right now. Take another look at this one. Take another look at this one. Leaning back on the ropes. Leaning back on the ropes. Take a look at this, would you, Jim?
I would think that George is going to shut a little too hard. Otherwise, he's just short up a little more. He's close to the man. He's not bringing way back. You don't need a big wide shot. All in the culture.
And the other tribute you have for us is to the referee.
I would say that's a very good job.
Here we go, the bell sounds. Round number 5, Ali stood through part of the round as he allowed Foreman to back him up. Foreman scored a pretty good right hand that time to the body of Muhammad Ali. Ali's face showing no signs of being hit at all as he takes the right left hand. This is a straight left hand thrown by Ali. Face of Foreman beginning to look marked. No cut, nobody's been down. We're in round 5. Foreman definitely has a puffy right eye. Straight left hand taken by Foreman. Ali continues to dodge to him. Foreman trying to back Ali up and really throws the right hand to the body of Muhammad Ali. Doesn't seem to bother Ali. Ali stands on his toes, works downstairs, goes downstairs. Good luck to Ali. Good luck to Foreman. Again, right hand of Ali going to the left side of the face of Foreman as the infighting is really better for Muhammad Ali upstairs anyway. Hits some real good shots. The ball is thrown by Foreman. Foreman on the left of your screen. Ali on the right. Ali leans up against the ropes. Right hand taken on the gloves by Ali. It's a real wild right hand taking the back of the head of Ali. Foreman with a wild right again. Ali looks like he's trying to rest in this round. Punches are not doing any damage though. Vicious right, thrown to the body of Ali. Wild right, missed the head of Ali. The left taken on the glove of Ali, the right glove. Foreman pouring, pouring, pouring. Foreman trying to set him up, trying to set him up to the body. Ali does look tired now. Foreman seems to be coming back with more steam. Scores with a light right hand. 1 minute left in round 5. This is George Foreman's round all the way. Ali, this is a cruising round for him. Foreman rolling away. And Ali sits in the back. Foreman just working the body. Hasn't hit Ali except once for the face. Neither fighter has him down. Ali picks it up a little bit, about 40 seconds left in round number 5. Separates the two fighters. Ali goes head on again. Oh, great left hand taken on the face of George Foreman. Ali scored 3 in a row that time. Foreman's right eye looking to be closed. Ali has tremendous look of confidence on that face. These punches are landing, bouncing off the eye of the heavyweight champion of the world, George Foreman. Foreman has his work cut out for him. Tremendous crowd here at 20th of May Stadium. Now Ali back represented by George Foreman. Long left on the break by Ali. Foreman has more team than he goes for, and he won't need military left. Ali leans on. Ali sits back in the ropes and tells Foreman to come in. Foreman looks like a bit arm worried, so that right hand is trying to set Ali up. Ali's doing exactly what he's actually not supposed to do, leaning up against the ropes and taking the punches of the heavy-hitting George Foreman. Foreman doesn't really look to have a tremendous punch anymore, but I'm sure that when he gets a little respite here, as they're cruising a little bit now in round six, that he'll be able to deliver the thundering, booming, rifling shots that he's capable of delivering at any time. 1 minute left in round six. Muhammed is allowing Foreman to come in on him, inviting him in, counterpunching, inviting him in, talking to him. Angelo Dundee screams from the corner, Ali, get off those ropes. But Ali continues to talk to Foreman. Straight left hand on the chin of George Foreman. Foreman falls in. He's looking for room to unload that right hand. 30 seconds left in the round. Now Ali squares away, watching box. He lets the foot on combinations in the last 2 seconds of the round. Right hand misses. That right hand scored by Ali. Look at these combinations. The speed of Ali at this point is outclassed with strength and booming punches performance. Neither fighter has been down. Round six.
Yes, I hate to predict any fight, but my goodness, those people who said Foreman would win in a flash have certainly been proved wrong, those people who said.
Here we go, round number seven, the fighters can't wait to get at each other. As this time, Big Foreman comes stalking across the ring, delivering some light hooks to the body of Ali that certainly are doing no problems or causing any problems to Muhammad Ali. Ali spins him around, out of the corner now. Ali is definitely in command as far as the movement in the ring is concerned. Foreman looking for the opportunity to unload. The left hand again in the face of Foreman. Definitely Ali is scoring more punches than George Foreman. The punches to the body of Ali are not hurting him. They're not taking a toll. The man is in tremendous physical condition in that part of his body. George Foreman tries to work again inside on Ali. Ali pushes his hand away. Again, Ali ties up George Foreman. Foreman doesn't look to have a good bounce in his leg anymore. But of course, Foreman being the one-punch artist that he is, who knows what may happen as the rounds continue. We're in round number seven, midway through. Straight left, and a good right hand taken to the side of the head. Attacked by Ali, jab the left, put the right hand, hang on. George Foreman, of course, famous for booming punches. Foreman continues to come in on Ali. He wants Ali bad, it's just a matter of trying to set him up to deliver the real heavy blow. Ali rifles on the right hand. Ali's face is not much. George Foreman gets in a pretty good left to the body that time, underneath the ribcage of Muhammad Ali. Punch was hard to see on television, but he did score a pretty good left to the side. Ali doing what he did to some smaller men, leading on George Foreman. There's a good right uppercut thrown by Foreman. Best punch he's thrown in a couple of rounds. Both fighters beginning to show signs of being tired. 30 seconds left in this round, so very even fight. Hard to tell exactly who will be out in front, perhaps by a point, maybe two, one way or the other. Looks like Ali could be out in front with the punches that he's throwing to the head of Foreman. Foreman tries to score some punches, definitely showing some fatigue in the waning seconds in round seven. Ali continues to talk. Foreman tries to deliver some shots to the body. The bell sounds, ending round 7. Here we go, the bell sounds, round number 8, in an even fight here, live via satellite, a video technique presentation worldwide. Ali working to the head of George Foreman. Ali scores again with a left hand. That time a straight left, bounces the head back to Foreman. A quick short jab with the right hand, bounces the head around to Foreman. Foreman looking to deliver the real heavy blows. Now he's bouncing there, almost falls out of the ring. Ali left that punch, pushes his body to the side, and the left hand went kind of over the shoulder. Ali pins him over. Zach Clayton right on the spot, the referee. Chairman of the Pennsylvania State Boxing Commission. Ali seems to be, well, kind of going the way he wants. He's not dancing as much as we thought, but he seems able to control him. Now, it's a pretty good heavy right hand taken on the left side of the cheek by Ali. Good right hand thrown by Foreman that time. Again, for Foreman, it seems to be one or two, maybe three good punches. That punch taken on the glove. That one slips by the left ear. Tries to go with that right uppercut that fells Kenny Norton. The left hand again thrown out by Foreman. Both fighters now very much more fatigued than they were around so ago. The heat is pretty high here, around 80 degrees. The humidity is probably 85 to 90. At age 32, Muhammad Ali is bouncing around pretty good for the 24-year-old Foreman, hanging pretty tough in there. Again, I caution you to look for the one punch that George Foreman can deliver at any time. This man is devastating, to say the least. These punches are not at this particular time. Try to pull a sneaky right hand on Ali. Ali hanging on, getting away with it. The left hand taken on the side of Ali's cheek. The left hook again on the side of the glove. Right hand by Foreman was not effective. Right up, that did bounce the head a little bit. Punches were not hurt. Ali just takes him. Protecting his face from all times, does Ali. Foreman throwing more punches now. Maybe this is a bigger tactic of Ali to let the man punch himself out. 30 seconds left in Ali. Very even play. Ali, a sneaky right hand. Another sneaky right hand. This time he works over the shoulder for him.
Bob Shane is climbing the ring to get to Ali. But he
He's not succeeding at the moment. There you see the pandemonium. There you see the pandemonium. One of the greatest fights of all time. There you see those are the Zaire versus the Hard Hats there, trying somehow to protect the two fights.
Angelo Dundee protected it. Angelo said he would knock him out.
Angelo came over here and waved to Jim and I. He put his thumb up as if to say, this was exactly what I did.
Well, I must make one point. Muhammad Ali had been waving at me, winking at me all night because he knew I thought that George Foreman would knock him out. And he is a friend of mine, so he was saying to me after every round, look at you, big fella, because I'm doing it. Fantastic.
Fantastic performance. There you see the stick in the ring. I can't see much hope of Bob getting a very deep, coherent interview at this moment. I don't think we're going to talk to Muhammad Ali in depth at the moment. But there you see the scene. The whole place is going wild. The people right at the back of the auditorium, they're on their feet too. They're on their feet. They're on their feet. There you see,
there's one thing about this.
Look at that face. Look at that face.
Oh,
a man who can scarcely believe what has happened to him. George Foreman, the man who was invincible. George Foreman, the man who was totally invincible. Is certainly suffering worse punishment in the middle of that ring at the moment. Worse punishment in the middle of that ring than he ever got from George Foreman. And there's George Foreman. Look at that. His head is fallen. He's really, really an injured man. And the man who said that could only play like a butterfly but not sing like a bee has really suffered. George Foreman, the beaten champion. What a moment of tragedy this is. He left here. There he goes. No one in the auditorium paying really any attention to him as he goes. As Muhammad Ali knows from that first fight against Joe Frazier, people are only interested in winners. Look at that sad, dejected head. Look at the people around him. Three or four people, maybe. Nobody wants to mob a beaten champion. There is the picture of the man who has undoubtedly fought his greatest fight tonight, won his greatest victory tonight, Muhammad Ali on his way to his dressing room. There he goes. Hooray, there you go. Hooray, there you go.
Amis sportifs.
Oh, and there are people trying to fight off the press, but there is the press of people, I should add, in case people think that that is a Nixonian attack on the media. With him just behind him, you may have seen Bob Foster there, fallen like heavyweight champion.
We see Muhammad Ali, the foe of the tyrant George Foreman. Ali unleashes a combination on the very fatigued George Foreman. Coming up here now. Right hand misses. Watch the left. There's the left. Now a straight right hand. That one spins his head. That's the knockout punch right there. It was a straight right hand taken right from the face of Muhammad Ali. This is the dressing room of Muhammad Ali. David Frost is making his way down there. Ali talking.